So People Can Fly are calling this their biggest patch ever. And well, it's pretty big. People have gone through it quickly and it's absolutely massive. Today we go through it all. How's it going, guys? My name's DPJ, and if you enjoyed the video, leaving a like really helps out. And if you like what you see and want to see more Outriders on a daily basis, be sure to subscribe. So this patch will go live today, and they make it absolutely clear that this patch does not restore inventories. They say these restorations and fixes are currently being worked up on, and they didn't really want to drop this patch before that happened, before they restored characters. But it seems as though they're having a few little niggling issues with that character restoration, so they decided to drop the patch, which will land today. By the time you're watching this video, I mean, it's probably installed. So let's get into the entire thing, people, and you'll see it on screen as I read through it. Okay, so the highlights you can see on screen now, but we're going to go through every single note. So let's go to them. So these general resolutions and changes that apply to all platforms unless stated. Fixed a number of large crashes throughout the game, resolved an issue that could cause players to get stuck on the signing screen, fixed several lighting, shadow and reflection issues within levels and cutscenes. General level improvements including fixing collision, textures, LOD, OOW visibility and grounded various floating assets. Also resolved a number of situations where the player could get stuck in the in-game world. Numerous cover fixes for specific locations including character alignment, cover to cover transition and blind fire. Camera movement has been improved during various cutscenes when smoothing is enabled. Improved visibility of the crosshair. Improved visibility of tutorial pop-up notifications. Side quest icons will no longer persist on the map after completion. The crosshair will no longer disappear when looking at allies. Fixed edge case progression blockers and objective issues in numerous main and side quests. Fixed an edge case issue whereby swapping characters would lead to a loss of the player inventory. Rebalance. The over-leveling system, scaling, multipliers have been adjusted. The system will activate one level later, when your average gear level is a minimum of 3 levels higher than the enemies you are facing. Previously it was 2. Now I wondered what this was. I mean, we've all known there's scaling issues with the game, but I was doing expeditions on stream the other day and I was helping somebody in all my basically what's challenge tier 15 gear, all level 50 gear. When I dropped that and helped him in a challenge tier 10, mate, I was getting brutalized. I don't even know what was going down, but it makes sense now. So outgoing damage will now be reduced, less improvements made to incoming damage scale, meaning players will feel more powerful without completely eliminating the threat of enemy NPCs. Conditions that will trigger the system have been cleaned up, which will eliminate unintuitive behavior such as damage increases when using lower level weapons. I mean, I made a video on this as well. It was absolutely crazy, the weapon scaling when you took a lower level weapon into a higher expedition or world tier. Okay, so on consoles, a UI scale option has been added to these settings. PlayStation reduced the sensitivity of the touchpad swipe, and PlayStation again resolved a crash that could occur after the open cinematic, with overall code optimizations made. Okay, so on to multiplayer resolutions and changes that apply to all platforms unless specifically stated. The default background matchmaking setting has been changed to closed, previously open. This change can be reverted manually in your settings. Fixed a bug that could prevent clients from joining the host. Resolved performance issues that appeared right after loading into a co-op game. Improved the loading time for players' gear when joining a co-op session. Fixed a bug whereby a client could load into a corrupted lobby if the host lost internet connection while loading into a game. Fixed an issue where the host would be unable to select a story point that other clients had not unlocked. A notification will now be disabled to the host warning them that the clients may not have unlocked the part of the story. Clients will now properly receive the story mismatch prompt when joining a host. Fixed a bug whereby a player with a complete storyline was unable to join expeditions if a story point before the end game had been selected. Fixed an issue whereby client characters might not properly spawn when re-entering expeditions. Fixed a number of bugs that could cause issues or errors to appear following a host migration. Fixed a bug that would cause players attempting to join each other's session to get stuck on a waiting to join session screen. Fixed a bug whereby trucks were no longer visible for clients when joining a host in the quarry. fixed a bug whereby the boss in the Eye of the Storm expeditions could appear duplicated for clients during cutscenes. Fixed a bug that could cause the client's map to fail to update after joining their map where the host was standing near a flag. Fixed a bug in a Dying Wish side quest where the host could get stuck in a quest area if the client disconnected. Fixed an issue where audio can disappear if host migration occurs during a cutscene. Xbox fixed a bug that could cause the game to lose functionality after signing out of a currently active account or suspending the internet connection during loading. Xbox again. Fixed a bug that could cause the join random team functionality to not behave properly. Xbox again. Fixed a bug that could cause the authentication process to fail due to an internet connection error. And Xbox finally again. Fixed a rare crash that occurred for clients when a host initiated a fast travel from the Desolate Fort. Okay, so on to gear and mod resolutions that apply to all platforms, again unless specifically stated. Crafting. Rebalance. Cost of improving rare to epic and leveling up gear from levels 1 to 30 has been lowered. This will make improving items cheaper in the early game. Fixed a bug where a skill damage improvement mod on gear with a higher level than the player would actually reduce damage when used at lower world tiers. Fixed a bug that caused the UI to display at 0 in the preview when upgrading the Hell's Ranger's weapons. Onto the trickster! Oh people, this is scary time, it's scary time! Okay, so fixed a bug that caused the trickster's hunt the prey skill to not teleport but still go into cooldown. Yes, this was annoying. Resolved instances where Hunt the Prey could be used to teleport to unintended locations. Fixed a bug that caused the trickster's Venator's knife mark to vanish after casting Hunt the Prey skill on the marked enemy. Fixed a bug whereby the Move Groove mod's anomaly and firepower buff icons did not appear correctly on the HUD. Okay, so on to the Pyromancer. Fixed a bug that was preventing the Pyromancer's Feed the Flame skill from applying the Ash status effect to Screechers. Fixed a bug whereby the Pyromancer's Phoenix Nesting skill occasionally granted the player the incorrect HP multiplier. It now grants the correct 50% HP. Fixed a bug that was causing Pyromancers to exit cover after using the Thermal Bomb skill. Fixed a bug that could cause the Pyromancer's boots of the Lava Leech legendary gear item to not include the appropriate mods. Okay, so on to the Devastator. Fixed a bug that caused the Perseverance mods with damage reduction buff to not correctly end after the Golem effect wore off. Fixed a bug with the Devastator's extra Quake mod, which sometimes provided more than one extra skill activation at the end of fights. Fixed a bug that caused lurkers affected by the Endless Mask skill to reappear on top of the player if you walked under them. Fixed a crash that could occur if you boulder dashed into a wall. Fixed instances of Gravity Leap causing players to get stuck in unintended places. Resolved instances where Boulder Dash could be used to reach unintended locations. PlayStation only. Improved the VFX of the Reflect Bullets skill to make it more visible. And onto Technomancer. A rebalance. The Minigun Mod Massacre, which was changed in the previous patch, has had its duration reverted to its original value, but will now only stack up to 6 times. Fixed a bug whereby a toxic lead armor mod was not triggering properly if an enemy was killed via a skill. Fixed a bug where technomancers would be stuck on their main weapon if they used Tools of Destruction and Pain Launcher at the same time. Fixed a bug with Tools of Destruction where melee or further skill use was prevented if the skill was interrupted by using the mouse wheel. Fixed a bug whereby the Perpetua mobile weapon mod was also replenishing the Technomancer's Tools of Destruction minigun ammo. Wow, I didn't know that was happening. Crazy. Fixed a bug that allowed the Technomancer's turrets to be placed on vertical surfaces. Fixed a bug that could cause the AI to ignore Technomancers if a turret had been spawned before the AI spawned. I actually thought that was intended, I didn't think that was a bug. Okay, so Xbox only deployed Technomancer turrets now correctly display the health bars. PlayStation only, fixed an issue that caused the Technomancer's shrapnel skill to break the sprint animation. And fixed the set description of the Borealis Monarch set in the English language. Okay, cool. So on to skills they say here. So skills can now be properly cast when using the targeting feature after changing the key binding. Improve the visual indicator of throwables. Okay, cool. Okay, so gear and mods. fixed a bug that was causing the certain mods to not properly trigger their unshot on critical shot effects if said shot was a killing shot. Fixed a mod that caused the anomaly surge tier 1 mod to not proc as expected. Fixed a bug that caused legendary set bonuses to not show correct items being active in the armor details. Fixed a bug that caused bright lights to appear on the screen when using the Stone Whip mod. PlayStation only fixed a bug that could cause the Legacy of Enoch achievement to not properly unlock. And minor visual fixes to female gloves. Okay, so onto enemies, boss, and NPC related resolutions that apply to all platforms unless specifically stated. Rebalance. All snipers now give players more time to dodge their shots. I mean, this was a bit annoying. It wasn't too bad of an issue for me, but I saw a lot of uproar about this. Reduce the amount of knockback from creatures in the Stargrave Expedition. There is now also a greater delay between spawns and a reduced number of the offending creatures. Molten Akari. Fixed a bug whereby the Molten Akari's jump attack was still damaging players who successfully dodged its AoE. Players successfully dodging AoE will no longer be damaged. Fixed a bug that allowed Devastators to permanently stun the Molten Akari by using the Endless Mass skill without any cooldown. Fixed a bug that caused the Molten Akari boss fight to pause for around 1 to 2 minutes if one of the clients disconnected right before dealing the finishing blow on stage 1 and transitioning to stage 2. PlayStation only fixed a bug that could cause the spiderlings to freeze during the third phase of the Molten Akari boss fight. Onto the Chrysaloid. Debuff icons applied to the Chrysaloid boss will now remain in between phases. Fixed an issue where the Chrysaloid boss fight does not progress if the player kills the boss during the black screen between phases. And Yagak. Fixed a bug that could give Devastators unlimited healing when using the Impale skill during a Yagak fight. PlayStation only fixed a bug that caused Yagak's tentacle ability to damage players before it actually landed. Fixed a bug that prevented the Brood Mother from dealing damage to the player with melee attacks while standing on an elevated platform located on the left side of the encounter area at the outpost gate in the quarry. Okay, so fixed a bug whereby the crawler ranged attack was damaging players beyond its attack range indicated by the UI. Yes, this was so annoying, people. Strikes or streaks, whatever those are, them annoying ass ugly ass butterflies, damn I hate these things, are now better able to cope with players standing too close to a wall. Great, just make them more powerful. Fixes to AI, including Berserker, Paving Optimization, skill usage, as well as reacting to and properly attacking players. Health bars for enemy skills, such as Anomaly Rifts, are now correctly hidden if the enemy health bar mode is set to hiding options. Animations for encounters have been fixed in certain situations, particularly when in cover and recovering from knockdowns. Fixed a bug that caused the effects for the weightlessness mod to now work as intended with crawlers. Resolved issues that caused the game to become unresponsive when interacting with NPCs, particularly when using skills or changing input methods. PC only fixed the crash that could occur during the enemy spawn in the first arena of the Kemplan expedition. PC only fixed a rare bug whereby players were unable to properly sell items to the vendors. Again, PC only fixed an issue whereby the cursors would turn invisible during dialogue with NPCs. PlayStation only fixed a bug that could cause Hardy's tent to disappear from the camp and fixed NPCs T-posing in certain situations. Okay, so on to quest and expedition specific fixes that apply to all platforms, again people, unless specifically stated. Fixed a bug that caused a stash to lock if the player died in a bad day side quest. Fixed a bug that prevented the Big Jaw Monster Hunt side quest from being completed if the player died during it. The navigation line during the Relic's main quest has been fixed. Fixed a bug that made the Historian quest in Deadrock Pass inaccessible if players initiate combat after triggering the exit prompt. Fixed a bug in the Sacrifice main quest that prevented progress by not updating the objective correctly. Fixed a bug that allowed players to charge the obelisk before the appropriate cutscene had been completed. PlayStation only fixed a bug that could cause the key to the radio tower to fall through the floor in Eagle Peaks. And PC only fixed a bug that could cause story achievements to not unlock correctly when their criteria was met. Okay, so audio and dialogue resolutions you'll see on screen now. I don't think this is insanely important to mention, but if you do want to read through that, you can just pause the video. But there's also a few other changes and minor bug fixes that apply to all platforms, again, unless otherwise specifically stated. We read through these because there's a couple of interesting ones here. Added protection for when claiming items from the inbox when stash and inventory items are full. A co-op exploit where multiple legendary rewards could be obtained from the historian bounty and monster hunt side quest is being fixed. No more legendary exploits, people. Fixed a bug that could prevent their player from claiming the world tier 10 weapon reward. Fixed a bug that caused the HUD to appear when players were only 8% loaded into levels. Increased the frame rate of the video clips on the class selection screen. Text corrections in the journal and tutorial screens, as well as miscellaneous localization issues. Fixed a bug that could cause incorrect color schemes to appear for the banner and truck customization. Fixed a bug that could prevent movement after exiting dialogue sequences. Fixed a bug that could prevent the inventory from opening if the inventory button was spammed. PlayStation only. Fixed a bug that caused the main menu to not play the proper music track. PlayStation again. Fixed a bug that prevented players from using the analog stick to select dialogue options when in conversations with NPCs. Again, PlayStation again. Fixed an issue that could prevent the English language download to not trigger properly and prevent the player from changing their languages to English. And additional backend fixes, people. And on screen now you're seeing resolutions that additionally apply specifically to PC. So if you want to read through all of those guys, if there's any issues I haven't covered already from this patch and you want to see if they've sorted them, you'll see them on screen now. But yes, people, that is the absolutely humongous patch we have for Outriders. Let me just switch my Xbox on now and see how big the actual patch is. I mean, if my Xbox hasn't automatically downloaded it, which is probably already done. In fact, at the time of me recording this video, I don't even think the update is out yet because I've got nothing on my Xbox so far. I'm just loading in to see if the patch number has changed, but I don't think it has. I think it's gone back to, it was 1.3.0, it's gone back down to 1.2.0, so we'll see in a quick second. But yeah, people, quite a giant patch, not gonna lie, a ton of fixes here. I will be streaming later to test them all, as you know, so I hope to see you there. But if there's anything else you've experienced which hasn't been mentioned here, I don't think they mentioned the Cyclone Slice. I haven't had a bug with that. When I come out of it, I can't run properly, especially if I'm playing with friends. Hopefully that is fixed, but we will see again later when I test these things. But yes, guys, quite a few fixes there for sure. Unfortunately, nothing's been restored in terms of players' inventories. But hold tight, I'm pretty sure they are still working on that. And actually, guys, I think I've installed the patch. Mine is now at 1.4.0, so my patch has installed by itself, so can't right now tell you exactly how big the patch was. If it was a patch you download and it wasn't a backend patch, we just don't know. But yeah, guys, the end of the video has now arrived. If you enjoyed it, leaving a like really helps out. If you're new around here and want to see more Outriders on a daily basis, be sure to subscribe. If you never want to miss a stream or video, make sure you turn notifications on by hitting that bell button. And hopefully, people, I will see you on that next one.